Good morning, good morning, love. It's my favorite love song. I waited all night long.
Yeah.
And some of the dry stuff.
Sit. Sit, boy, sit.
Sit down.
Hey.
What?
Hello, girl.
I was talking to Pina.
She's already sitting.
Oh, this one's a little Speedy Gonzales on the flats. I think we can take your training wheels off this weekend. Then you'll have to balance.
They're pretty easy balancing.
I can't balance with chain wheels. They're annoying.
Come on, eat that because we've got it stuck.
Thank you.
Mike, your placemat's wet. Grab a dry cloth. Dry it, please.
Shove that in your mouth. I want you to wash your hands, please. Yeah, hurry up. Just go in the house, mate.
Sit down.
Sit down.
I turned to the right page.
You just turned to it, did you?
Yep. Come on, boy. An accident.
Really?
Yeah, chapter 4. First try.
I don't think your sister wants your elbow in her face while she eats.
I don't think I want it in my face.
I'm just guessing, it's just me. You can check with her.
I don't think I want it in my face either.
Stop it.
She definitely doesn't want your underarm in her face while she's eating. That will change the flavour of the fluid completely.
Breakfast all right, guys?
Mm-hmm.
So about 12 o'clock, Luca, I'm going to take you over to meet the builder, Lucas and Torres. And Brandon, you've got to go at 3:30, is it? To Domino's. How about that? You only applied for it yesterday.
Today's yeah.
Got your first interview today. Exciting. You have to make sure you sound like a complete pizza aficionado. Eat, sleep, breathe, worship pizza. Yeah? Can we have pleasant conversation with that audience, Sandy?
This is probably in the wrong cup.
It's because it's still juicy.
You know what? I'm not going to drink it now. In fact, I'm going to hold my breath.
You're not holding my breath. It's still the same water.
Shush. Boring. Let him fume. He's going to prove his own point now. You know what? No, he's not. You're being stupid.
Let's drink that water. It's not that bad.
We have to have kindergarten bubby conversation, do we?
Drink your water.
Yeah, we could take that.
It's hard to be grumpy when you're ticklish, isn't it? How are we going to fix that problem? Come on.
Dad!
I got my water right there.
Stop it.
Sorry. All right, we're going to start. So sit up. Sit. Get all your coughings and splutterings and yawnings and fartings and everything else you want to do. Get it out. How about you try it now?
Can I please have a tissue?
Make my editing job a lot easier.
Excuse me. What's that? West.
We'll go pick it up afterwards.
Okay, elbows off the table because you can't see. Where is your book? This is your book here. Page 8, is it, Robert?
Sure it is.
Spit out of my hand.
Enough. Morning, everybody.
Shoot.
Welcome back to our brekkie bar.
What did you say?
Shoot, I forgot my glasses.
You just went up a minute ago. What did you go up there for?
I don't remember.
I love how hilarious.
You went up there for your glasses.
I love how
Can
hilarious.
You please go and get them?
It's hilarious, isn't
okay.
it?
You've got 5 seconds, so I'd be hightailing. Not too loud up the stairs. See it, Vivian? Good job. You know why I'm saying that? It's actually an ad. It said, sit, boo boo, sit. Good dog.
I think it was at the end of every Cosby show or something.
Give it to me. Give it to me.
Come on, come on. Let's do this.
Let's start again, eh? Morning, everybody.
Morning.
Welcome
Morning.
To our Brekkie Bar. We're up to chapter 4 of Mark today. Aaliyah, can you start, please?
Another time, Yahushua began teaching by the lake, and a large crowd gathered around him. So he got into a boat so that he could sit and teach from the lake. And all the people stayed on the shore near the water. Yahushua used parables, stories, to teach them many things. One of his lessons went like this. Listen, a farmer...
Stop. Peanut, go.
Listen, a farmer went out to sow seed. While he was scattering the seed, some of it fell by the road. The birds came and ate it all, Other seed fell on rocky ground, where it grew, where there was not enough dirt. It grew quickly there because the soil was not deep. Then the sun rose and the plants were burned. They died because they did not have deep roots. Some other seed fell among thorny weeds. The weeds grew and stopped the good plants from growing, so they did not bear any fruit. But some of the seed fell on good ground. There it began to grow and made grain, bearing good fruit. Some plants made 30 times more grain, some 60 times more, and some 100 times more. So if you've got ears, listen to what I'm saying to you.
Okay. So in this, we are told that Yahushua's out by the lake, just decides to get in a boat because of the large crowd that's forming. That way he can teach the people. And he tells them stories to teach them. The reason he's telling them stories to teach them is because it's easier for them to understand, because they do this sort of thing themselves. So there's people who sow seeds and harvest grain. There's some who are shepherds. So they're having livestock, whether it be sheep or goats or cattle. Yeah? That's why he's telling them stories, in order for them to understand what he's trying to tell them. So he's told them this story. A farmer went out to sow seeds. Some of the seeds fell by the roadside. Now, if they fall on a road, is it going to grow?
No.
Why not?
Because it's made of stone.
Made of stone. There's no soil there, is there?
Mm-mm.
Okay. Then the next one fell on ground where there wasn't enough soil. So what happened to that seed?
It dried up.
It burned.
Well, it said it grew quickly. It grew quickly, and then what happened?
The sun rose and the plants were burned.
That's right. All because they didn't have a good root system, because there was no soil for them to have a good root system. Yeah? The next one fell among thorny weeds. What would happen if that happens?
They get choked out.
They get choked out. Correct. And they die. And some of it fell on good soil. What's the good soil?
Thick.
Yeah?
So it can make its roots good.
Makes the roots thicker, stronger.
Yeah? You said Yahusha. That's very good. Because the good soil comes from Yahusha. So you're very, very, very close. Yeah?
It's the word. The spirit.
So the good soil is us feeding the seed in order to grow, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Because we all receive a seed when we're immersed, don't we?
Yeah.
Some people have it in good soil, some people don't, even though they've been immersed. Yeah? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And then it says some plants produce more than 30, some plants produce 60, some plants produce 100 times more. Yeah? So from that story, Yahusha's telling us that we need to keep our seed in the good soil. And what's the good soil?
The word. Yahusha. The Torah.
The Torah. The word. His living word. Yeah? Helps to keep us in the right place. On the right path. The bad soil is who?
Satan.
Yeah, that's right. So you can see why Yahusha's telling them stories about different things, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? Alright, Mikey, you're up, mate.
Later, Yahusha was away from the people, and his 12 close followers and others asked him about the stories. Yahusha said, "Only you can know the secret truth about Yahuwah's kingdom. But to the other people, I simplify it all using stories. I do this so that they will look and look but never really see. They will listen and listen but never understand. For if they saw and understood, they might change and be forgiven. And does it look like they want that?
Keep going, man.
Then Yahusha said to his followers, "Do you understand this parable? If you don't, how will you understand any other story? The farmer is like someone who plants Yahuwah's perfect word in people. Sometimes that word falls on the path. That is like some people who hear the words of Yahuwah, and as soon as they hear it, Satan comes and takes it away from them, takes away the word that was planted in them. Other people are like the seed planted on the rocky ground. They hear the word, and they quickly and gladly accept it, but they don't allow it to sink deep into their lives. They keep it only a short time, and as soon as trouble or pressure comes of the word they accepted, they give up. Others are like the seed planted among the thorny weeds. They hear the word, but their lives become riddled with the worries of life, the love of money, and everything else they desire. This chokes the word from growing, so it doesn't produce any fruit in their lives. And others are like the seed planted on the good ground. They hear the living word and accept it. Believe, obey, surrender, listen, and do. They grow and produce a good crop, sometimes 30 times more, sometimes 60 times more, and sometimes 100 times more.
So see, here's your thing going on to explain to his followers, because they didn't understand it. It wasn't that they didn't accept him, was it?
No.
So he's told them exactly what it means. Yeah?
He's introducing a new spiritual component, divine dimension into their lives. Heaven. All they knew about was seeds and sowing and planting and reaping and harvesting. They were agricultural people. He's using all their language, as Trey said, to teach them something spiritual that can mean something to their life. He's relating everything they do year in and year out to the kingdom of heaven. Having that inside you, that seed. He's trying to use very simple language so they'll get it. Does it look like they're getting it?
No.
Well, his disciples were.
Yeah, the only people that weren't understanding what he was saying were the people who weren't chosen.
He had a small amount of time to get all the healing and all the speaking and all the preaching and all the effect he could do. He had a small amount of time, so this was his way of weeding out those who weren't really interested. I'll keep the story very basic and simple. Oh, that was a lovely story, let's all go home now. And then there were those that would come up to him afterwards and go, what did that mean? And there were the genuine ones. Then there were those who were furious at him, as Brandon said the other day, trying to stalk him and hunt him out, so they wouldn't even understand the story at all. They couldn't catch anything out with that story, could they?
Nothing.
So he's playing very clever. Such a clever person. Knew all the old laws, knew all the stuff that was going on in heaven, and he brought it all together to make it effective in their hearts.
Brandon?
Then Yahusha said to them, "You don't take a lamp and hide it under a bowl or a bed, do you? Of course not. You put it on a lampstand. Everything that is hidden will be revealed and made clear."
Stop. Read that again.
"Everything that is hidden will be revealed and made clear."
Everything that is hidden will be revealed and made clear. Remember that phrase, that sentence. Yeah? Keep going, mate.
"And every secret thing that will be brought into light and made known. You people, if you You people, if you think you've got ears, then listen. Think carefully about what you're hearing. You will know how much to give you by how much you understand now. And he'll always give you more than you deserve. The people who have some understanding will be given more. But those who don't have much will lose even the small amount they have. Then Yahusha said,
Stop. So, as you said, would you take the lamp and hide it under your bed?
No.
Or under a bowl?
No.
Why not?
Because it goes on the bedside table.
Because that would obstruct the light.
That would obstruct the light. And yes, it does go on a bedside table, or a table, or somewhere.
A lampstand.
A lampstand. That's right. Back in their days, it was a lampstand. So, why did Yahusha say that? Everything that is hidden will be revealed and made clear. Why? Why do you think he said that?
Because truth always comes out.
Good. Yep. That's exactly right.
And then everybody would eventually know that he was Yahusha.
That's right. Everything that is hidden will be revealed. Remember that.
Mm.
Because if you do something wrong, who knows?
Yahusha.
And who will reveal it?
Yahusha.
Because the word is will. Yeah? It will come out. It will be known.
It's true.
Whether you want it to or not. So if you've stolen something, if you've hurt somebody and lied about it, Yahusha knows every single thing that you have done.
Pass that to him. Got a hairball.
Oh, phlegm.
Take that. Use the whole thing.
Yeah, no more tissues. No more tissues.
Try and eat that towel.
So, be careful what you're hearing. Think carefully about what you're hearing. Yeah? You've got ears to listen, don't you?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have ears to listen? Mm-hmm. What about you guys? Yeah? So you hear the warnings that are being given within the message, yeah? Do something wrong, it'll come out. Do something good, it'll be revealed too. So it's not just wrong that gets revealed. It's the good stuff that you do too. Because sometimes you might do something good and nobody else knows. And then something might come up and it gets revealed. And I didn't know you did that. Really? Well, that was great. Yeah? Stop, Robert.
Don't look over here. This is a constant distraction. Constant distraction all morning. Just look at Therese, all right? This won't stop. Don't worry about this, all right?
Okay, look at he's telling us to listen to everything that he's saying and be as good as we possibly can. Because if we're not, he knows. He knows everything. He knows what you think. He knows what you're behaving. Everything. And if it's not good, kind, loving, peaceful, patient, and you don't have any self-control looking at you in particular, exactly, see? Like that. He knows. What does he do when we do something wrong?
He punishes us.
He flogs us.
What's he do?
He flogs and guards us.
Both of you at the same time. That's fantastic. Look at that. The youngest one and the second oldest. Both at the same time. Woohoo!
People can't see your handsome face if you've got your hand up here like this.
So that's what you've got to remember from that. Yeah? Everything will be revealed that is hidden. And remember, will.
Will.
That's the word. It will happen. Yeah? Who hasn't read yet? Joan?
Then Yahushua said, Yahuwah's kingdom is like a man who plants seed in the ground. The seed begins to grow. It grows night and day. It doesn't matter whether the man is sleeping or awake. The seed still grows. He doesn't know how it happens. Without any help, the ground produces grain. First, the plant grows, then the head, and then all the grain in the head. When the grain is ready, the man cuts it. This is the harvest time.
So, from that story, Yahushua's saying, Yahuwah's kingdom is like a man who plants a seed in the ground. So the seeds grow. Because we had the seeds planted in us, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
So the seed's growing. How come it's growing in us?
Because we're the temple.
Because he planted it, because we're the temple, and what else?
Because we have the word.
And what are we feeding?
Our seed.
With what?
Kindness,
the Torah.
The word. Yeah? Is the seed going to grow if we're not feeding it?
No.
If you don't water something, it doesn't grow, does it?
Mm.
It'll die. True? So that's what he's saying in there. Then it keeps growing even overnight because we've taken the information in and it starts to sink in. And we're listening and we're doing what Yahushua wants us to do. And someone might say something and you might start to get angry, but if you go into your portal and speak to Yahushua, he will tell you the right thing to say.
And check the rules.
Yeah, with the three rules, that's right. That's why I said you might start to get angry. But if you go into your portal, you're not going to get angry, are you? Not at all. Then once you've done that, you come out again, and there's what? What's he say? The seed grows, produces what?
Grain.
Grain. So first the plant grows, then the head grows, then the seeds in the head grow. Then what's the time for?
Harvest time.
Harvest. Who's he harvesting?
Us.
That's it. We're his harvest. Yeah? Understand that?
Do you remember when Yahushua said, because he's talking about seed and the harvest, man plants a seed. Do you remember in a different parable he did where he said his plant, the enemy came and planted all this wicked seed in between it? Remember that one?
Mm-hmm.
Let's talk about the head. Do you know what a head of grain looks like?
Mm.
It grows up and it's got all these spikes and things in it. long thing with all these spikes in it. Is it light or is it heavy?
Heavy.
Big, the more mature the wheat becomes, the heavier the head becomes. And what does it do in the wind?
Bow down.
Mm.
That's exactly right.
The wicked seed, the weeds, the darnel, they don't have the maturity of the head in it. They just stand up straight and tall and proud, strong.
And they don't bow down to you.
What are the wheat doing?
Bowing down.
Remember he said, the servant said to him, should we go and pull out all these weeds now? And he goes, no, don't do that. You might pull out some of the good seed as well. Wait until harvest and it'll be obvious. There's one standing up straight and the other's bowing down. What does that say about our behaviour? If the head's growing, if we're maturing, what does it say about our behaviour? Should we be proud?
No.
Loud? In control of everything? Letting everybody know? Do you think I have to talk without you coughing at the top of me? Victoria did a lovely message, amazing message yesterday about kindness, and she said, being kind is to bow down. She looked in the Hebrew and it said, being kind is to bow down to someone who is inferior. Do you know what inferior means? Do you know what superior means? If someone is superior to you in life, it means they're better than you. If someone is inferior to you, it means they're not better than you, they're less than you. So do people normally bow down to someone who's superior to them?
Yes.
No. They don't.
Not at all. You bow down to someone, you come under someone who's better than you or more powerful than you or your boss or your parent or you. There's a pecking order in life generally. People think there's a pecking order in the assembly as well. But do they base it all on behaviour or do they base it on knowledge, money and wisdom and all that sort of stuff?
It's not based on knowledge.
Hmm. What does Yahushua base the maturity on? What's he looking for?
Behaviour.
So if you see somebody who is superior to you, not in a, oh, I'm better than you way, but in a, they can't behave as good as you, they're not mature as you yet, and you can bow down and be kind, you see that's what Yahushua's looking for? But in order to do that, you've really got to empty yourself out, kill this thing called the flesh, and go, they should be respecting me, and they shouldn't be, they, no, you've got to get, do the rules, as Hunter keeps saying. Am I taking this personal? Am I letting them have it? You let them have it and you bow down to them and you flow with it. Being kind. Can you be kind to someone today? That's the seed. That's the harvest he's looking for. People who are willing to bow down, get rid of their ego, because most people in life operate on ego. And they're stalking every conversation that they're in to try and get an in to talk about themselves. Oh, yes, I did that. I've done that. I've been there. I've done that. This, that, this, that, this, that. If you can do the opposite and be humble, that's the maturity. That's the harvest he's looking for. We should watch that video Victoria did. We'll do it tonight.
Mm. All right. So you can see from just these few little stories so far what Yahushua's asking of us. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
You can see that? Who hasn't read yet? Would you like to go next?
I want to read a longer one.
Just read.
Can I read?
Just go read.
Then Yahushua said, what can I use to show you what Yahuwah's kingdom is like? What story can I use to explain it? Yahuwah's kingdom is like a mustard seed, which is smaller than any other seed on earth that you can plant. But when you plant it, it grows and becomes the largest of all the plants in your garden. It has branches that are very big. The wild birds can come and make nests there and protect it from the sun.
All right. Keep reading.
Yahushua used many parables like these to teach people. He taught them all they could understand. He always used stories to teach them. But when he was alone with his close followers, Yahushua explained everything crystal clear to them.
All right. Stop there for a minute, Hunter. So he's told us the story about the mustard seed. Do you know how big a mustard seed actually is?
About that big.
It's a bit bigger than a pin. The size of a you know how thick a pin is?
Like one of those black seeds you get on your bread roll.
Well, that's small.
That's tiny.
Yeah.
I mean, like those seeds on...
You know, like a poppy seed, for example. Yeah. It's about the size of a poppy seed. You know, the... When you get the orange and poppy seed cakes and you see those little black seeds in there.
Are those the seeds on burgers?
Yeah.
Sometimes, yeah.
Yeah.
It's the smallest seed that produces anything. The smallest seed that produces anything. Has anybody ever seen a mustard tree?
No.
They are massive. They grow so big. Trunks that you wouldn't even be able to get your arms around. I think you need about 3 people. That's how big they grow. So from this tiny little seed to this huge tree. So we got that tiny little seed in us.
How powerful is it though?
Very powerful.
Yeah? That tiny little seed.
It's gonna go powerful. Mm.
We have to keep feeding it and feeding it and feeding it in order for it to grow into that massive tree that it becomes. So that is us affecting our behavior and just getting better and better and better, like Yahushua's. Yeah? We can't do that if we're not behaving the right way. Understand?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Luca, loud voice, mate.
That day at evening, Yahushua said to his followers, "Come with me across the lake." So they left the crowd behind and went with Yahushua in the boat he was already in. There were also other boats that went with them. A very bad wind came up on the lake. The waves were coming over the sides and into the boat, and it was almost full of water. Yahushua was inside the boat, sleeping with his head on a pillow. The followers went and woke him, saying, "Teacher, don't you care about us? We are going to drown." So Yahushua stood up and gave a command to the wind and the water. He said, "Knock it off. Quiet. Be still." Then the wind stopped and the lake became calm. He said to his followers, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no belief?" They were petrified and asked each other, "What kind of man is this? Even the wind and the water obey him."
Wow. Could you imagine that? You're out on the lake, open seas, wherever it is, and there's waves crashing onto your boat. Has anybody seen movies like that?
Yeah.
And what are the people like on the boat?
Dead.
Scared. Terrified.
Terrified and scared.
Scared out of the skin.
Yeah. Imagine how the followers of Yahushua were.
Very terrified.
They were so petrified that they were going to die. What didn't they have?
Belief.
Belief. correct.
Belief in what?
Was Yahushua worried?
No.
What was he doing?
He was sleeping. Yeah.
Knocking out some Zeds, wasn't he? He was a bit tired.
Yeah.
Can you stop now?
Okay.
Thank you. So Yahushua's there, having a bit of a nap. He was tired from all the healing and all the teaching and everything he's doing. He didn't get much sleep most of the time because everybody just wanted to be near him and have him heal them and teach them. And could you imagine having to do that day in, day out? And barely getting any time to sleep? Plus having the worry of what's about to happen to you? Knowing that you need to get as much of this word out as you possibly can before your time comes.
Mm.
Yeah? The disciples, believers, followers, whatever you want to call them, said to him, "Teacher, don't you care about us? Really? See their lack of belief in just that statement? Don't you care about us?" Imagine that. Here's Yahushua, just trying to get a bit of a, you know, sleep in, because he doesn't get much of that when he's around everybody. And all they were worried about were who?
Themselves.
Yeah? I ain't having that. I'll just keep throwing some water out. What's the difference? You can see what he's doing, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
You can see how exhausting his work is. Well, that's the work that we're meant to be doing as well. You've seen Dad and I pretty exhausted, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Because we're trying to do Yahushua's work. How often are you guys that exhausted?
Never.
Never? Why never?
Because I don't work.
Are you doing Yahushua's work?
Yes, you are. You're learning to play the guitar, learning to praise, learning his word. If you don't know it, you can't give it to anybody else. If you don't know it, you can't give it to anybody else, can you? Shouldn't run yourself down.
No.
Take it from the expert.
I've actually seen some of you so exhausted that you can't even keep your eyes open. Can you leave that alone? It's the last time I'm telling you. Because I'm about to smack you in the head.
You're about to get it in stereo.
Get rid of that demon that's inside you now. Because I'm done with it.
I'd sit still for 2 hours watching TV.
So in order for these guys to be saying that they didn't have the belief in Yahushua, did they? What does Yahushua do?
Knock it off.
Alright, that's enough. Stop that. Be still. No more. And what happens?
It stops.
How can he do that? He must have made it. He must have made it, created it, in order to control it, wouldn't he?
Mm-hmm.
He's slowly showing them that he's the creator that everyone's been talking about for thousands of years, waiting for the deliverer right here in front of them. And they still, even when he died, didn't really fathom it completely until they got this spirit in them. And then all the pieces of the puzzle came together inside them, and they went bang, 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 and he inspired them, and then they could have these amazing flows, like your mum's getting every morning, just piecing all the bits of the puzzle of the scriptures together, and his spirit just empowers it to whoever needs it, whatever ears require, the right word in the right moment. Victoria said that too, having the right word in the right moment for people.
So after he said, stop it, he says, why are you so afraid? I've been afraid. Because I don't know what's going to happen. I've seen things. And I'm thinking, don't know about that. Don't know if that's going to work. And then what's Yahusha done?
The opposite.
Shown me that it does work. So I've been, yeah, I know that needs to happen, but I'm not sure it's going to work. I'll step out and do it. And let's see. Let's see if that was right. Let's see if that was Yahusha talking to me. Because sometimes it's not Yahusha telling you to do it. It might sound like him because it's something similar to what he'd tell you. But then what happens?
It backfires.
Doesn't work.
Backfires, you fall on your face. Oh, well, that definitely wasn't him.
So you fine-tune the voice in your ear.
So then you say to him, sorry. I thought that was you. Obviously it wasn't. But there's one time that you will know it's definitely him. Darling, can you tell them when that time would be?
When he comes back?
No.
I don't know.
When it comes out of the mouths of how many? Usually two or three.
Two or three?
Yeah.
If it's confirmed by others. You can run it by others, yeah. Get confirmation with other people. Definitely.
There's been times where Dad and I have both heard the same thought. And then we've gone, think we should do this. Yeah, I had that same thought.
Yeah, that's happened a couple of times.
Confirmation that it's Yahusha telling us to do that.
Mm. So if you're not sure, run it by someone else.
Adoption. Sometimes we even run it by Chris and Victoria and they go, yeah, we heard that too. Wow. Yep, it's definitely confirmed then, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
When three or four people have all heard the same thing. So that's what you can do too, yeah?
Getting to know his voice.
You can come up to Dad or myself and say, I heard this. And you usually talk to us at the same time as you're telling us. And we can say, nah, that's not your usual. Yeah, give it a go. He usually said he wants you to try it. Give it a go. Yeah? So that's what you've got to understand is you've got to have the belief. Everything that you do will come out. Anything that is hidden will be revealed.
He wants to come close to every single one of you. Every single one of you in every aspect of your life to help you, encourage you. He's not an ogre. He's not the harsh taskmaster that the servant last week accused him of when he buried his talent in the ground. Not harsh at all. If you hear in your head that he's harsh, who's that?
Satan.
Satan. about last week, Brandon, when we're deciding what we should, what you think you should do. You know, I'm not sure. So, well, give it a go. Try it. If it's not from Yahushua, it won't work, you won't be satisfied, this, that. You've completely come out of yourself. Complete, again, changed. So happy, haven't you? I didn't know that it would work. I didn't know if it would cost money pulling out of school. Didn't know if we could afford. Turns out it's fine. You can get a job. You might be able to get two or three jobs. And what happens the first time you apply for a job? Get a call back straight away. That don't normally happen, does it? Things like that. It's not huge wisdom and knowledge and learning the scripture from cover to cover. It's very practical things in life. Yahushua's in all the little practical things. He's going into one scripture there. He said, how, let me think. How am I going to explain this kingdom to you? How am I going to explain it? And he looks around and they're all people walking past with seeds and harvesting stuff. And okay, I'll use that as an example. Do you think he uses seeds and harvest to talk to us today?
No.
He uses the salon for us. If he really wants to get our attention, he'll give us a couple of slow weeks. That gets our attention. So you've got to look in your own personal life, what affects you. Oh, I think Yahushua's showing me something here. This isn't working. I don't feel very happy this week, or maybe I'm not getting any shifts, or maybe I'm not, for those of you who work, maybe something's happening. You know, Joe's about to get a license. Maybe Yahushua will show you. He shows you in all your little things in life. Friends, family, school, if you're at school. Oh, what's Yahushua showing me here? He's not going to use agriculture and seeds and plants unless you're a gardener. He uses things that are in your life. So, got it? He wants to come close in every little moment of your life. How many thoughts does he give us?
More than the grains of sand on the earth.
Have you ever tried to count them?
No.
No. That's how many thoughts are there for you if you tap in. But we're too busy. And Satan's taking your life day after day, knowing that Yahushua wants your life to love you and give you good things, and show you good things, show you amazing things in his word and in life. Because what's happening to the time? I've downloaded all these clips and we're about to put it together into a short presentation of current events. So you can see, because you all live in a little bubble. You're like me, you just want to watch things that are silly and funny and comedies and this, that. None of us watch the news. So we're all just in this little bubble. So it's time we actually saw global events. So you can see, you're in one of the safest countries in the world. So even that, you don't even see what's going on. Apart from you guys a bit, we didn't even have to wear face masks. We didn't even get touched by COVID here. We had to close for maybe 3 days. Barely had to. You guys have been to Melbourne, you saw it. You guys were in Sydney, you saw how hideous it is. Even Australia didn't really get touched much compared to other countries. People dying left, right and centre. Anyway, that's enough from me.
So you understand what Yahushua's saying to you? Step out in belief. Yeah? That's what he's telling you. Step out in belief. Sometimes it's hard. But if it's him, it will work. Just like everything that is hidden will be revealed.
Always.
Just like you think your demon that's in you is hidden, it's being revealed to everybody every time we're on camera. Yes, I'm actually talking to the demon. Not to my son, Robert, who's loving, kind, generous. All the things that Yahushua wants.
Demons hate being revealed. They want us to think it's us.
The demon keeps controlling you. And I'm tired of it controlling you. I'm tired of the demons controlling all of us. But we're stupid because we allow it. Because we entertain those thoughts. So time to put off those thoughts. Tell them to bugger off. No, not listening. No, not doing that. No, that's lies.
Demons don't want you to be happy. Demons don't want you to express yourself in your life. Demons don't want you to praise Yahusha. Demons don't want you to be rejoicing and celebrating. It's demons.
They want you in misery.
Misery.
For the rest of eternity.
So how about you just stick it up them and do the opposite to what they say?
Whoever's doing that, stop, please. So we've got to understand, we all need to step out in belief. You've finally stepped out in belief. And what are you now?
Happy.
Great. Are you a girl or a boy?
Girl.
Great.
Happy girl.
Happy girl. You still haven't, because you want that demon to control you. You can look at me with those squinty eyes, demon, but in mind. All you like. But I've seen you in control, Robert. And I've seen you out of control. I need you to step out in belief that Yahusha will do what he says he will do. And that is heal you. You don't believe that in your heart. You're just paying it lip service right now. Because of the demon that's in you. And it's not going to work if you're just paying it lip service. Am I right? Sorry?
Yeah.
Yes. You can't just say that you believe it. Because Yahusha knows if you do or don't. Yeah? He knows every thought, every action, every behavior. He sees all. And he will reveal everything that is hidden. And he's revealing to you that you don't believe. You're just paying lip service to it. That's what he's revealed to you in this message today. Hasn't he?
Yes.
What about you guys? What's he revealed to you guys? John?
To believe more and trust him.
Believe and trust more?
Do what he says.
Yeah. What about you, Brandon? He's showing you, hasn't he? By believing and trusting what he says.
Yeah.
Hasn't he? What's he given? What's happening with you today? What have you got?
An interview.
An interview.
Yeah.
Because who did you believe and trust?
You sure.
Exactly. You believed, you trusted, and you did what he told you. And you've at least got an interview, possibly a job. We can't say definitely a job.
You get a job.
But I have that feeling.
I could tell by the way the guy was talking.
Yeah?
Really positive.
Now the other thing is, what about you, Mikey? What's he revealed to you in this today?
Probably the littlest action can just, like, cause, like, something big to happen.
Yeah.
That's good. That's good. Littlest action can cause something big to happen. And that could be what?
Anything.
Two different things. Could it be good or bad?
Good and bad.
Good or bad. That's it. The littlest action can cause something big to happen. We've seen the littlest actions cause something big to happen. We've also seen some bigger action cause something even bigger to happen. And that's been changes in people.
Mm.
Who's seen a change in Brandon? All of us, yeah? Who's seen a change in Pina? Yeah? Anybody seen a change in Robert?
Yeah.
A little bit.
Big time. Big time, mate.
We just need that action that we've had to get the bigger change. That's why we keep bringing that demon out and revealing it. Yeah? Because we want him gone. Okay? Because what do we want for you?
Me to be healed.
You to be healed. I know you want it. I know in my heart that you want it. But you've got to believe it. Okay? And that's for all brothers and sisters out there.
Yep.
All believers. You must step out in belief. Not just pay lip service to it. On that note, guys, have an awesome day. Love you.
Finish the dishwasher. Hold on. Wait. Dishwasher. Don't worry about the books. Dishwasher. Good job.
Good morning. It's a beautiful day when I'm with her. With me, she lays. Good morning. Another beautiful day. The sun rises when I see your face every day. Good morning. Good morning. Sometimes good morning. It's a beautiful day when I'm with her. With me she lays. Good morning. Another beautiful day. The sun rises when I see your face every day. That you breathe, every day that you see is not guaranteed, oh no. Every morning, every morning. Good morning, it's a beautiful day when I'm with her. With me she lays. Good morning, another beautiful day. Good night.